गुड आफ्टरनून. ट्रैफिक इंजीनियरिंग वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन सम इंट्रोडक्शन सम पार्ट ऑफ द ट्रैफिक इंजीनियरिंग. सो द टेलीकम्युनिकेशन सिस्टम हैज़ टू सर्विस द वॉइस ट्रैफिक एंड अ डाटा ट्रैफिक. टेलीकम्युनिकेशन सिस्टम हैज़ टू सर्विस द वॉइस ट्रैफिक एंड द डाटा ट्रैफिक. And the traffic is defined as the occupancy of the server. So the basic purpose of the traffic engineering is determine the conditions under which adequate service is provided to the subscriber. What is the basic purpose of traffic engineering? The basic purpose of traffic engineering is to determine the conditions under which adequate service is provided to the subscriber while making the economical use of resources providing the service. So the function which is performed by the telecommunication network depends on the applications it handle. Some major functions are switching, routing, flow control, security, failure monitoring, traffic monitoring, accountability, internet working and network management. So these are the functions which are performed by the telecommunication network. To perform these functions, a telephone network is composed of a variety of common equipment. To perform this function, telephone network is composed of variety of a common equipment such as a digit receivers, call processor, interstage switching link, inter-office link, etc. Thus, a traffic engineering provides the basis for analysis and design of telecommunication network or a model. So it provide means to determine the quantum of a common equipment which is required to provide a particular level of service for a given traffic pattern and volume. And the developed model is capable to provide the best accessibility and a greater utilization of their lines and trunks. Also the design is to provide the cost effectiveness of various sizes and configuration of network. The traffic engineering also determine the ability of a telecom network to carry a given traffic at a particular loss probability. So the traffic theory and a queuing theory are used to estimate the probability of the occurrence of a call blocking. Earlier, the traffic analysis, which is based purely on analytical approach that involved advanced mathematical concept and complicated operations research technique. So present day approaches combine the advent of a powerful and affordable software tool which aim to implement the traffic engineering concept and automate a network engineering task. So in the study of teletraffic engineering, to model a system and to analyze the change in traffic after designing, the static characteristic of an exchange should be studied. The incoming traffic undergoes a variation in many ways, and due to the peak hour, business hour, season, weekend, festival, location of exchange, tourism area, etc., the traffic is unpredictable and random in nature. So traffic pattern, or we can say a traffic characteristic of an exchange, should be analyzed for the system design. The grade of service and the blocking probability are also the important parameters for the traffic study. टेलीट्राफिक मॉडल्स आर इनवैल्यूएबल टूल फॉर द नेटवर्क प्लानिंग एंड अ डिज़ाइन. सो दे आर यूजफुल इन द एरियाज सच एज नेटवर्क आर्किटेक्चर कंपेरिजन्स, नेटवर्क रिसोर्स अलोकेशन एंड परफॉर्मेंस इवैल्युएशन ऑफ अ प्रोटोकॉल. The traditional traffic models have been developed for a wireless network, and these models predict the aggregate traffic going through a telephone switch. So, they do not include a subscriber mobility or a call distribution, and therefore, it need a modification to be applicable for modeling PCS traffic. Now, the statistical description of the traffic is very much important for the analysis and design of any switching network. So, first is the calling rate. This is the average number of requests for connection that are made per unit time. So, if the instant in the time that a call request arises is a random variable, the calling rate may be stated as a probability that a call request will occur in a certain short interval of time. So, if n is the average number of calls to and from a terminal during a period t second, then the calling rate is lambda is equal to n by t. So, in telecommunication system, the voice traffic and the data traffic, these are two types of the traffic. The calling rate lambda is also referred as average arrival rate, and the average calling rate is measured in calls per hour.
the next is the holding time. The average holding time or the service time, which is represented by H, it is the average duration of the occupancy of a traffic path by a call. So for a voice traffic, it is average holding time per call in hours or 100 seconds. And for data traffic, the average transmission per message in second. So the reciprocal of the average holding time referred to as a service rate, that is mu in call per hour, which is given by, the formula is given here, mu equal to 1 by H. Now the most commonly used distribution is the negative exponential distribution. So the probability of a call lasting at least t second is given by the formula pt equal to exponential of minus t by t. Now for the mean holding time, if h is 100 second, then the negative exponential distribution function is shown by this figure. Then the distribution of a destination, so the number of calls which is receiving at a exchange may be destined to its own exchange or remoted exchange or a foreign exchange. So the destination distribution is described as the probability of a call request being for a particular destination. As the hierarchical structure of the telecommunication network include many intermediate exchange, so the knowledge of this parameter helps in determining the number of trunk which is needed between a individual centers. Now the user behavior. So the statistical properties of the switching systems are a function of the behavior of user who encounter a call blocking. The system behaves differently for a different user. So the user may abandon the request. If his first attempt to make a call is failed, the user may make the repeated attempt to set up a call. Otherwise, the user may wait some time to make the next attempt to set up a call. And this behavior varies person to person, and it also depends on the situation. So the next is the average occupancy. Now, if the average number of calls to and from a terminal during a period t second is n and the average holding time is h second, then the average occupancy of the terminal is given by A equal to nh by t, which is equal to lambda by mu. Thus, the average occupancy is the ratio of average arrival rate to the average service rate. It is measured in Erlang. The average occupancy is also referred as the traffic flow or the traffic intensity or carried traffic. Now the next is the traffic pattern. So an understanding of the nature of the telephone traffic in its distribution with respect to time, or we can say traffic load, which is normally 24 hour, is essential. It helps in determining the amount of lines required to serve the subscriber needs according to the need of telephone subscriber. So the telephone traffic varies greatly, and the variations are not uniform and varies season to season, month to month, day to day, and also hour to hour. But the degree of hourly variations is greater than that of any other period. So various parameters which are related to a traffic pattern are, the first is the busy hour. So busy hour means traditionally a telecommunication facility is engineered on the intensity of the traffic during a busy hour in the busy session. And the busy hour vary from exchange to exchange, month to month, day to day, and every season to season. So the busy hour can be defined in a variety of way. It can be defined as the 60-minute interval in a day in which the traffic is highest. So taking into account the fluctuation in the traffic, the CCITT's recommendation is 1600 define the busy hours the continuous 60-minute interval for which the traffic volume or the number of call attempt is greatest. So this is called as a busy hour. Now what is peak busy hour? So it is the busy hour each day varies from day to day over a number of days. Then time consistent busy hour, the 1 hour period starting at the same time each day for which the average traffic volume or the number of call attempt is greatest over the days under consideration. So in order to simplify the traffic measurement, the busy hour always commences on hour, half hour or a quarter hour. It is the busiest of such hour. The busy hour can also be expressed as the percentage of the traffic occurring in 24-hour period. Now, what is call completion rate? That means CCR. Based on the status of the called subscriber or the design of switching system, the call attempted may be successful or not. So the call completion rate is defined as the ratio of number of successful call to the number of call attempts. So the CCR value of 0.75 is considered excellent and 0.70 is usually expected. Now the busy hour call attempt, so it is an important parameter in deciding the processing capacity of an exchange, and it is defined as the number of call attempt in busy hour. Then busy hour calling rate, it is also useful parameter in designing a local office to handle the peak hour traffic. It is defined as the average number of calls originated by a subscriber during the busy hour. Also day to day hour traffic ratio. Now what is day to day hour traffic ratio? It is defined as the ratio of busy hour calling rate to the average calling rate for that day. So it is normally 6 or 7 for rural area over 20 for city exchanges. In units of telephone traffic, so the traffic, it is also traffic intensity is measured in two ways. One is Erlang and the Saint Call Second, that is CCS. What is Erlang? The international unit traffic is international unit of traffic is Erlang. So it is the name after the Danish mathematician A.K. Erlang. who laid the foundation to a traffic theory in the work he did for the Copenhagen Telephone Company starting in 1908. So a server is said to have one lane of traffic if it is occupied for the entire period of observation. So more simply, one lane represents one circuit occupied for 1 hour. Now, the maximum capacity of single server or a channel is 1 erlang. So the maximum capacity in erlang of a group servers is merely equal to the number of servers. So for example, the problem on traffic engineering, one is the Saint Call Second, that is CCS. It is also referred as a 100 call second. Saint Call Second means it is also referred as a 100 call second. So the CCS as a measure of a traffic intensity, it is valid only in a telephone circuit. Okay, it is valid only in the telephone circuit. So the CCS represent a call time product, and this is used as a measure of amount of traffic expressed in units of 100 second. Now sometimes the call second and the call minutes are also used as the measure of traffic intensity. So the relation between the erlang and CCS is given by 1 erlang is 36 CCS, that is 3600 CS, which is 60 centimeter. So the grade of now the next is the grade of service. So for non-blocking service of an exchange, it is necessary to provide as many lines as there are subscribers, but it is not economical. So some calls have to be rejected and retried when the lines are being used by other subscriber. Now the grade of service refers to a proportion of unsuccessful call relative to total number of calls. So GOS is defined as the ratio of lost traffic to offered traffic. Now what is GOS formula? It is equal to blocked busy hour call divided by offered busy hour call. So it is also given by A minus A0 by A. Now what is A0? A0 means carried traffic. What is A? It is offered traffic. And A minus A0, that is offered traffic minus carried traffic, which is equal to lost traffic. Now smaller the value of GOS, that is grade of service, the better is the service. The recommended GOS is 0.002, that is 2 call per 1000 offered may lost. So in a system with equal number of servers and the subscriber, the GOS is equal to a 0 and it is applied to a terminal to a terminal connection. But usually a switching center is broken into the component. One is an internet call and second an outgoing call to a trunk network, that is switching office to trunk. Third the trunk network, that is trunk to trunk. And the fourth is a terminating call, that is switching office to the subscriber. So GOS is calculated for each component which is called a component GOS, and the overall GOS is in fact approximately the sum of component grade of service. So there are two possibilities of call blocking. One is loss system and second is waiting system. Now what happened in loss system? In loss system, suitable GOS, that is grade of service, is the percentage of call which are lost because no equipment is available as the instant of a call request. And in waiting system, what happened? A GOS objective could be either the percentage of the call which are delayed or the percentage which are delayed more than a certain length of time.
Thank you.